Let's get you introduced to the data template and data journal by first looking at an existing data template that has been built to bring in basic default information for a parent event frame and two levels of child event frames. Then we'll start with an empty data journal and show you how to build this. First, let me open a report for editing by going into the RtReports editor. This can usually be found under the PySystem folder. And I'll go to RtReports editor. And I'll log in with my credentials. I want to open an existing report, so I'll go to File, Open. And we're going to take a look at the Potion 1A compliance report. Over here on the left, I have the option to switch between the format template and the data template. And I want to start by clicking on the data template. And over here on the right, I have the option to switch between the report and the journal. And I want to make sure I'm looking at the data journal. The data template here on the left contains the rules for retrieving data, but it doesn't actually include any data. We can see here that there are different levels. There's a batch level, and then these are unit batch levels. And then under those, there might be some journal actions or even some sub-batch levels. Later in this video, we'll be showing how to build the unit batch levels and these sub-batch levels. And then different videos in this series is going to show you how to bring in different custom things like the pH tag data or the heater current data through journal actions. There'll be separate videos on bringing in each of those types of items. So this first level here is the unit batch, and we're using the filter mixing star. And if we want to compare this to our event frame, what this is going to do is look for any of the three unit batches that we have here, our first child event frame level, and look for only those that have an element associated with them that starts with the word mixing, because we used a mixing star. So it's only going to bring in information for these two. And then this is what it looks like in PySystem Explorer. The second one that's configured is going to bring in information only for those unit batches or child event frames, first level child event frames, where the associated unit starts with the word heater. In this case, out of these three that it's going to search through, it's only going to find this heater step one because the element here starts with the word heater. And again, this is what it looks like in PySystem Explorer. Now we also want to bring in information for this next level down, for the heater elements, which are down here. However, at the next level, here we've used a subbatch, and our filter criteria is HElement star. And that's because at the next level and all further levels down, instead of looking at the name of the unit, we look at the actual name of the event frame. So at this level, it changes. So now we're looking at the subbatch level. So by setting it up this way, what information are we actually bringing into the journal? So first we need to associate this data template with a context or an event frame. To do that, let me go to View, Test Report, and say Use Event Frames. And an event frame search window will come up. Let me go under Connection Options and connect to my AF server. And the database I want is the production database. Under Search Criteria, I like to uncheck all descendants. And then let's just look at event frames from the last 2 hours. And I'll go ahead and select event frame 2173 and click OK. Now to actually pull in this data into the data journal using the data template rules, I'm going to make sure that it refreshes by hitting F5. Let's take a look at the journal that's created by associating this data template over here on the left with an event frame. When I open up the journal, I can see here that there's a product and a recipe. And those correspond to the product and recipe at the parent level event frame. We can also hear that there's information on the start time and end time, as well as the duration, and other information here as well. And we'll be showing later how to pull these actually into your report. We have three different unit batch journals, and those correspond to our three unit batches here. If I open my first one, you can see that there is a batch ID, product, and procedure name, as well as an associated PI unit. Those correspond to the batch ID, product, and mixing unit shown here. However, since pH is a custom attribute, it won't show up by default in the data journal. We'd instead have to add a journal action. There's also information associated with the start time, end time, and duration. If I open up the second unit batch journal, you'll be able to see that it's associated with mixing unit 2. And both the first and second one come from this entry here. The third one corresponds to our heater unit 1, which was created by this section here. Again, there's the batch ID, product, and procedure, as well as the associated PI unit name, heater unit 1, and the start time, end time, and durations. Inside of this one, there's also a subbatch level with two subbatch journals, and those are created by this entry here, HElement star. If I open this, you can see that this one is associated with HElement 1, and this entry is associated with HElement 2. Let's go ahead and build this together from scratch in a new report. Let me go to File, New, Batch Report Template. I'm going to name this report Potion 1A Compliance. RFN frames have recipes and products associated with them, and this is part of the procedure level event frame. Some of our event frames have a product of Potion 1A, while others have Potion 1B. And we'd like that this report to only be valid to be run when the event frame has a product of Potion 1A. So I'm going to insert that here into our product. Once the report is released and ready for printing, if you select an event frame with a product something other than 1A, you won't be able to generate this report against that context. And I'm going to click OK. And to check on that filter setting, I'm going to just quickly go over to the format template, which we haven't discussed yet. Right-click on the top level and go to Property. I'll go over to Criteria, and you should see here that the product that this report is valid for is only for Potion 1A. I'll go back to the data template, and I can create a batch journal over here on the right if I choose to associate with this an event frame at this time. So let's go ahead and say test report, use event frames, and the connection to my database still exists here. And under criteria, I'm going to again choose star minus 1 day. Click search. And it looks like they gave me descendants. So I'm going to click search again after I check that and uncheck it. And I'll just pick one. I'll see if my journal updated. And sure enough, it looks like it did. I have a batch ID here, along with the product and recipe, and again, start and end time. However, you'll notice at this point, I don't have any unit batch journals because I haven't created any criteria over here to bring those in. Let's start by creating the unit batch level in our data template. Let me right-click on batch, say insert, and I'm going to say unit template. And this is the naming criteria for the element associated with your unit or first level child level event frame. If I go over to my PowerPoint, I want to be able to bring in both of these items, so I'm going to use mixing star at this level. And I'm going to click OK. And this shows up here. Or go to view refresh, my journal will update. And now I have two unit batch journal items. And these are both coming from Mixing Star. And what do they look like? The first one here, the unit is Mixing Unit 1, and the event frame name is Mix Step 1 to 2171. And that is associated with my unit names over here, and then my names of my event frames over here on the left. If I look at my second unit batch journal, I can see here that this is Mix Step 2 and is Mixing Unit 2. And let's do the same for the heater. So under Batch, I'm going to say Insert, Unit Template. And in this case, my search criteria to find all the units that I need to bring in is going to be associated with the name of the element, because I'm at the first child event frame level. So I'm going to use Heater Star. And click OK. And then go to View, Refresh. And then the third unit batch journal shows up, which we didn't have before. And if I open that up, sure enough, it has a PI unit name corresponding to heater unit. And the event frame name on that was heater step 1. Within a heater unit, I also want to bring in information related to the next level of our event frame at the sub-batch level. To do that, I'm going to go under Heater and say Insert, Subbatch Template. Now, at the first child event frame level, you base the search criteria on the name of the primary element, which in this case was Mixing Unit 1, Mixing Unit 2, or Heater Unit 1. But at the subbatch level, the search criteria I use is associated with the actual event frame name. In this case, HElement 1 or HElement 2. So under my name here, I'm going to type in HElement with a star and click OK. And then I'm going to View, Refresh. If I look under one of my mixing unit batches, there's no subbatch journal. But if I look at my third one here, my third unit batch, there are subbatch journals, and there's two of them. If I open them up, I can see that they are associated with my heater elements. Now, if these filter criteria don't work for you for mixing and heater, there is such a thing as a unit class, which lets you group like units together, even if they don't have similar naming conventions. And in addition to bringing in basic information for the unit level, unit batch level, or the sub-batch levels, there are a lot of journal actions that can bring in additional information. And these journal actions will be used to bring in information related to the pH, or you can bring in static information off custom attributes, like the serial number. And these will all be discussed in separate videos. The journal action that you set up here in the data template, when associated with an event frame, is going to pull that information into the journal over here on the right. But it doesn't actually put it into your report. Once it's in the journal, you can then set up the format template to format the report. As one additional item, for tech support cases, we may request the data template or the data journal. The data template is the information over here on the left. And the data journal is the data specifically once you've selected an event frame. And we may request these for troubleshooting purposes, and they can both be exported by going to File, Export, and then here's Export Data Template, and the Data Journal once you've selected a specific event frame.